I like how there was a tug of war of dick right now. That's hot.
No, you suck it. No,
that's
you
actually
suck
how
it.
Band practice happens.
No, you suck it. No, you suck it, friend.
They were tussling.
It's actually part of our songwriting process.
Yeah, the tussling. Fuck? Tussling.
Low-key, I gave that shit a name. It's called Denzel to me.
Denzel.
My nigga.
All right. I like how there's already, like, there's craziness happening in the studio. There's dicks happening everywhere.
There's extra
weird shit.
Wet backiness
there's
going on in here.
Dude, there's a lot of fucking wet backs tonight.
Yo, I'm
missing.
Well, listen, Central America or Mexico doesn't matter. Anything south of these fucking U.S.
Everyone sells oranges by the freeway. It doesn't matter.
It's all wet back.
It smells really bad in here. You know what? And it's not the badger's vagina today. It's the weirdest.
It smells like fucking lawnmowers in here. It smells like a ton of fucking lawnmowers in here.
I smell oranges and
like fucking churros, papitas, fritas. You know, it's like all that shit.
It's probably just me and Jovan. I have no papers. Jovan has no papers. Probably just us.
That is correct, sir. That sounds about right. You look like you don't have papers.
Mario, let's get the show started before immigration shows up.
There we go.
Just me and Jovan.
Donald Trump all the way.
Welcome to Pix Radio. It is that time, Sunday.
I know you don't like that. I was waiting to see what you're going to say. Like,
you're a dick. You're a fucking dick.
I was like, what the fuck is this?
People, let me tell you about my best friend. He's a warm-hearted person who loves me till the end.
Cheers. You're listening to Pigs Radio, broadcasting live from a secret location in Compton, California.
Secret.
The talk show that makes psychiatrists see other psychiatrists. Other psychiatrists.
Other psychiatrists. Other psychiatrists. Pigs Radio, the long-awaited, unforeseen 190th episode of
190th.
Pigs Radio. 190.
Are you fucking
190.
Sure, though? 190.
Hold on. Judges, vagina? Yes, it's been verified.
We were just in the 60s.
No.
Fuck you.
It's been a while since
we're about to hit your birthday again to be another birthday episode.
Very true. Glad episodes. You brought that up.
Goddamn fucking whore. Ah, shit. Anyway, it's Pigs Radio episode 190, and the only way to celebrate it is with a lot of Mexicans and breeders and whatever else in between, and Central Americans. And
a bunch of illegal motherfuckers.
Jews.
In here, dude. Straight up.
Wait, we got Jews in the house?
Really?
So someone said Jews. I'm like, wait, there's Jews?
They said Jews.
Oh,
Jews.
Is it juice?
I got the juice.
Oh, okay.
Yada yada yada.
Man, juice.
Jew and Jew are here. And Jew.
This is gonna be an interesting episode. Let's see.
Very much so.
You know what?
Seems like it.
Let's see if we can try to get to the intros. And always in her vagina. Guys, just to let you know, she does suck dick for a living, and she will let all you guys inside at the same time. Right? You need,
she
to,
welcomes
you need to talk
you.
To
she
the mic. Can't
you.
Hear you.
At what rate?
Oh, at all rates and for free.
Yeah.
All rates and
pro bono. She'll take coupons, too. If you got a coupon,
like,
she'll take it.
So she'll say, like, I'm not a whore, but $2 is $2.
I got ABT.
Padilla, have your present for next year.
Wow.
She's Pigs Radio famous, our very own whore of the house. Let's give it up for Badger's vagina. Badger. 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 Fucking sucks. Fucking whore.
Baggy, dirty cunt. Oh, I'm sorry. Did I say that out loud? I'm sorry.
I thought it was one of these guys. I was like, wow.
Like, they already know you so well.
You fucking have it already?
Take that, bitch.
They are fucked up.
I got EBT.
Damn.
Wait, someone says they have EBT? I don't know
I
what
swear that.
That
was me.
I'm down for some cheese.
All right, there you go.
Buy her some groceries, nigga.
And looking like he has a lot of dick cheese from the Cyclone.
No. I just washed up.
Okay.
So I ain't got no dick cheese on.
Let's
right
give it up for the one and only.
Get at me later,
very
though.
Mysterious, the very niggiest mystery nigga.
What's up?
What's up?
Compton, CPT, motherfuckers.
Wow, this is the first time we actually get like a whole room clapping for you. I like that.
Nice.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Thank you. We're going to see them.
They're clapping for dick cheese. Of course they would.
Of course. Yeah. Come on. I'll pass it around later.
It's very powdery.
Wait, the dick cheese?
The clap?
Yeah, I'll let them smell it.
Oh, dude, that's so... gross. All right, so in the room, the only way to celebrate episode 190, other than putting Badger's vagina on blast, we have the one and only Mata Mosca. What's up, guys?
Yeah, hey, what's up?
Hey. All right, they brought a posse with them. They brought managers. They brought a bartender. They brought all their
girlfriends. Listen, this is just the horn section. You know what I mean? This isn't the drummer's not here, I'm assuming. No singers. It's just a horn section.
I have a dancer dancing in the background now. Is that your guys' cheerleader? I don't know who she is.
We're both Mata Mosca and friends.
We're what the 90s used to call.
Go-go dancer.
Dude, we're go-go dancer?
We're what the 90s used to call a ska band.
What are those? What are those?
Ska was really cool in the 90s, and then it went away.
No shit.
You know, yeah, I'll give it up. I give it up to Real Big Fish. They're trying really hard still, and they're still touring.
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah.
Oh, yeah,
but
really.
Mata Mosca is holding it down. Okay, let's see. How are we going to start this?
I know. It's a fucking mess here, dude. It's like you got people fucking everywhere. You got
okay.
people.
Okay, I'll tell you what. We'll start from this guy. Let's get your name, the position you play in the band.
Position?
Your position you love to play in the band, and your
Members.
Best. And
Doggy
your,
style.
And
Doggy
your
style.
Best.
Power
hold
bottom.
Hold on. And your best dinosaur impression, all right? And then we're going to go this way. Go.
My name's Danny. I play lead guitar.
That sounded like a pterodactyl getting run over by Fred Flintstone.
I thought it sounded more like a pterodactyl getting fucked, but whatever, you know what I mean?
That's exactly what it was.
By a badgerosaurus or what? Yeah. So, all right, Danny. I forgot. Wait, lead guitar you said?
Yeah.
All right, cool. Who we got here?
My name is Padilla. I'm the rhythm guitar and lead vocalist, and my best interpretation of a dinosaur would be Denver the Dinosaur Skates. High five.
By the way, I couldn't hear anything after all the bass in his voice. It was just like,
I sing for a band.
That's low key for I got a big sack of ball. So.
In his face.
You have Badger's attention now. That's all you have to say.
He was like, I got a big ball.
Yeah. Now, we were informed before half the group got here that they were partying at some baptism, some Chuck E. Cheese, and they're all drunk. So, all right, so that's what we got. All right, so who we got here?
Oh, my name's Richard, and I play the drums. And dino impression.
Talking to the mic, man. Talking to the mic.
Do Barney.
Burr, I guess. I don't know.
What the fuck?
That's not an answer. Dude,
that's the
By the way, all you did was
Fuera.
Burr.
Barney burping.
Fail.
Bro.
All right.
That's the
all right, here we go. Plaid shirt right here.
Confused Stegosaurus.
Hey, what's up, man? I'm Esteban Flores, and I'm backing vocals and keyboard, organ, whatever.
The organ.
What do you mean, whatever?
El órgano.
He likes to play the organ.
I like to touch the organ, you know?
And skin flute, too.
Too.
Of course he does.
Giggity. He's the hairy bagpipe player.
Dinosaur impression?
Do it.
Do Barney.
Come on.
Do it.
Put it together.
I love you.
That doesn't count.
Bye-bye.
Go on. You see Jurassic Park, Jurassic World?
That's very metaphorical.
All right. All right. So dinosaur intestines.
Brontosaurus taking a shit or something.
I like it. All right. You know what? It's the best one so far. Dinosaur taking a shit impression. I love it.
Sounds legit.
All right. Who we got here?
I'm Hector. I play the bass.
Hector, let's have you talking to the mic. How about fire some mic to your mouth? There you go. Put it in your mouth like a big dick. Yeah.
Lip to tip. Come on now. Lip to tip.
All right, let's try that again. Let's get your name again.
All right, Hector, and I play the bass.
All right, Hector. And your best dinosaur impression.
Well, I don't do impressions, man.
All right, well.
But you're a bass player, though, right?
I don't know what that means.
Bass player, job.
Oh, okay. All right. I don't know.
They try to copy a guitarist, you know.
Gotcha.
Whatever.
You said he's a replaceable one in the band.
Oh, totally.
Oh, okay.
Another guitarist. Give him two less strings. He's your bass player. Wow.
All right. We're going to introduce the band's entourage. We have these guys on the couch. Oh, he's a band member too?
He's a band member.
Oh, why the fuck you guys make him sit on the couch? That's fucked up.
He's over there macking
out. You made me sit on the couch.
Well, you didn't say anything.
He's doing his business.
It's your house.
Okay, cool. You're like, hey, I came with my chick. Is a party here? Like, all right, yeah, come in, dude. Fuck it, whatever.
Like,
you didn't check credentials or anything. All right, what's your name, dude?
All right, I'm Jovan. I play the alto tenor sax. I do backup vocals, too. Interpretation of a dinosaur?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes, please.
Char. Charmander.
Char. So we know who the biggest nerd in the group is, for sure.
Fuck it, he's in line for Star Wars after he leaves here.
I know, right?
He left his I want a new droid, a DD-8.
All right, and I'm assuming that's your girlfriend?
It is indeed.
All right. You get a point just for having a girlfriend. I didn't
better
know.
Better hope so. Yeah.
I didn't. There you go. Yeah, nerd power, freaking getting chicks and shit. Now, yes. Did you get her after you got into the band? After you became cool with the band, or
actually, no. We met at a nerd conglomerate.
Somewhere
in Orange County.
They're cosplaying. They're fucking off cosplaying at Comic Con.
Fucking Millhouse over there.
I choose you.
I thought that word would tickle y'all brains. Yes.
I see it happening right now. Yes. All right, my dear. What's your name? And why are you dating him? Does he have a big dick or a little one?
A big one.
Really?
Little.
Oh, wow.
Tiny, I've seen it.
A big little one. That's what I heard. A big little one. All right. All right, so then we have...
the giant midget.
We have a guy with a beard over here. What's up, Beardo the Weirdo?
Beardo the Weirdo, yo.
Yeah, beat you to it.
My name is Wilbur, and hype man. Yes.
You're a hype man.
Hype man.
All right.
So you're on stage also. You're also on stage.
So
he passes out your flyers.
He's
basically.
Our bartender. Sleazy manager.
So what I heard.
Mr. Burns.
What I found out before we started the show that he used to be the original band member. One. Apparently got kicked out, but he's still hanging out with the band. So he's one of those psycho
ex... So he just doesn't get it.
Yeah, it's like one of those psycho ex bitches that just don't know how to say, it's over.
See, you guys got to sack up and you know what, dude?
It's never over.
It's fucking over. Just get the fuck out, dude. Come on, man.
It would never be over.
They like don't love you anymore.
It would never be over.
It's over.
Like the band
never.
Best.
Never.
Like the band
okay,
bestie.
All right, hold on, hold on. I want to hear what Wilbur said. So actually, Wilbur, give your dinosaur impression, please.
Come on.
That's
primate. Like a monkey more like a primate.
Yeah, I think I'll take it.
It'll work. It'll work.
Is that even a lizard, dude?
That's like a lizard, yo.
Sounds like a monkey choking on dick.
All right, and we have one more go-go dancer. Now, I heard that she was managing the band and fucking one of you guys, so I don't know which one is true or not.
Or both.
Or both. Which one is it?
Or all of them.
You're boning this guy?
Wow.
This guy looks homeless out of everyone in the band.
I know, dude.
What the fuck? This guy can't even comb his hair.
I thought he was a bus driver or some shit.
By the way, he was working at the strip club, too.
She's like, tell them why.
Tell them why.
The reason why I be fucking
up. Oh, okay. Why is she fucking you? Do you owe her money?
Oh, it's chaos.
He's got that good credit, son.
She want to be a homeowner one day.
That's right. My FICO score just went up, because I'm fucking you, nigga.
I got that Curaçao credit, yo.
That's the worst kind of credit there is.
Yeah, I only have to put 50% down. That's it.
You're going to get like 5 calls. And that's it.
Wait, is that why? Because he has a Curaçao credit card? Because why?
That's bomb shit.
Because he's packing? Yeah?
A cuete or what? Are you going to shoot somebody up right now?
Packing heat, homie.
Don't be fucking blasting on fools.
Packing another bowl. That's what
he's packing heat, homie.
This guy. He says he'll put Big Blue to shame and shit.
Damn.
Prove it.
All right.
Prove it.
Whip it out.
Prove it. Prove it.
Prove it.
Bounce it. Bounce that dick, son.
All right, so now that we know who everyone is, and I already forgot everyone's name, by the way.
Oh, yeah, I don't know. It's still back to fucking Wetbacks and shit. What else I know.
Tell.
Guinness on Wetback. Guess it's so good.
Tell the audience, where can we find Mata Mosca music at? Can we steal it? Is it for sale?
Oh, yeah.
What the fuck?
You can definitely steal
hit
it.
Hit me
you
up. I'll give it to you.
You're giving that shit away for free?
Yeah, just give it. Just hit
our,
me
our
up.
Our keyboard just is like it. Black markets our music, low key. But no, you can definitely go to iTunes, Spotify, Google Music. You can go to Pandora and you can check us out. Just Mata Mosca.
Oh, Amoeba too.
Amoeba. If you wanted to buy an actual CD, you go to Amoeba Records.
Do people still buy CDs? Is that a thing?
Every once in a while, you get some white boy in Walmart and shit, you know,
vinyl,
buying a CD.
Vinyls and tapes.
Yeah.
We got tapes. We got all that stuff in our shows and stuff like
tapes?
That.
Tapes? People still use tapes nowadays?
Dude, tapes are awesome.
What the fuck?
We're catering to that hipster
really?
Community.
Yeah. Fuck yeah, dude.
Collect
yeah,
hipster money.
You know what, dude? We're going back into the 90s. We got ska. We got tapes. We have you with your fucking wallet chain. Like,
that's
dude,
motherfucking right, dude.
I'm going to go look
for my... I haven't lost my wallet since, though.
I'm going to go look for my Airwalks, and then the circle will be complete at that point.
We'll
be
done. Don't forget the Skechers.
Is your wallet chain the one that folds, or is just like in one, like it'll hold $1 bill without folding?
No, it folds. Sure. It's a tri-fold.
No, you gotta have the one that doesn't fold at all. It's
oh, no. We need that fucking for the greaser guys and shit.
Those are purse, chick wallets at that point and shit.
Chick wallet with chains.
Chick wallet with chains.
Yeah.
All right. So let people, where can we find the shit at? Online, anywhere other than...
Online, YouTube. We got videos. We just recently released a video, and we're going to release a new video called Beer Goggles.
It's Friday. It's
Beer
Friday.
Goggles.
Yeah. Yeah.
Can I guess what that's about? Badger.
I knew it. I felt
it's about
it.
The one that got away kind of thing. So.
Oh, I've been thinking about that lately. Aw.
Boo, you. Boy.
Shout out, Cesar Tejeras.
1246 Barbershop.
That's right, my son.
Well, you broke up with him.
We broke up.
By the way, I talked to him. He said he didn't break up with you. You broke up with him.
All of a sudden.
All of a sudden.
You know what? We should give him a call and ask what the real truth is.
Get the real fucking story.
Dude, we should get the real fucking story.
Call him right now.
Because it's not fair, eh? Poor guy, man. I saw him. He was all devastated and shit cutting Mario's hair.
I'll be like,
it's all fucking bummed out.
I know.
He was weeping. He was weeping while cutting his hair.
Look, I talked to him about it.
He fucking greased up his hair with his tears.
No.
Instead of using badger grease.
Extra shine.
Extra hold. Extra hold tears.
I got the real story. And for what
you
he
got
said,
the real story?
I got the real story.
Wait, how can you get the real story when you are the story?
Because I was drunk.
All of a sudden.
Wow. There you go. You see?
All of a sudden.
I was drunk dialing, and so what had happened was apparently we both didn't make time for each other, and I said, that's not true. And then he said, no, we both didn't. And he said, it is what it
did
is.
Did you tell him about all the like 12 other dicks what you suck while talking to him?
Oh, yeah.
That's not true.
Okay, you were sucking there. You're getting slapped around and all that bullshit, but whatever.
No, that's not true.
All
that's
of a sudden.
True. I was dedicated. All of a
since when?
For like a week.
All right.
But that's, you know, once I was serious, I was serious. And then he fucking broke my heart.
Whatever, dude.
I know. No one believes you have a fucking heart.
Wah, wah, wah.
Shut the fuck up. Wait up.
All right, so for those who don't remember ska from the 90s, we're going to play a track. Actually, I don't know how. I mean, you guys have a new song that got released. It was apparently the guy who's no longer in the band, still in the music video, as a bartender.
DJ, sir. DJ.
All up in the video.
He's a DJ?
Well, whatever the fuck you're doing, you're doing something on there.
Amazing.
Okay. And
not
then
amazing enough to stay in the band, though.
Damn.
Yeah, sorry about that.
Sorry about that.
Good luck, hey, but I heard passing out the flyers, this dude is bomb as fuck, dude.
Yeah, right.
We got the way out. Come to our next show.
Come to our show.
I'm still in the band.
Free surfaces.
We're by
get you on the list.
All right, so there's a YouTube video of the song called Mario Bros Before Hoes.
Yeah.
Is that right?
Yes.
And this was filmed by Marco too, someone who actually designed our own logo back here. So, by the way, that logo's actually tattooed on her ass, and there's a scratch and sniff on it too. So,
can I see this afterwards?
Ask her about it. Yeah, totally.
Can I see it after?
I keep forgetting about it until you bring it up, and I'm like,
scratch
what?
And sniff
oh,
tattoo.
Yes.
Wait, about the tattoo or about the scratch and sniff?
Both.
Both.
Picks or it didn't happen.
Do you want to tell people what the song's about?
It's called, it's actually about masturbating and crying at the same time and playing video games.
Hey, Mario, that's your favorite pastime.
You. What the fuck?
That's Mario's favorite pastime.
You don't even have to ask him.
Oh, my God. Yes.
You're all about it. You're all about it.
So we're going to give you a second to go grab some fucking tissues and lotions or whatever you do, and we're going to check out with some Mata Mosca.
I do it all.
On Pigs Radio. Listen to this shit. Hold on. Play some fucking play.
Hurry up, fucker. Play.
Wait. These motherfuckers didn't bring me any fucking music. I gotta go on the YouTubes and shit. All right,
fucking
here we go.
SoundCloud.
the new 4G phones. The Sprint HTC Evo and the Sprint Samsung X are here. Both have flash players, so you can stream the radio live anywhere in the country. So
if you okay, I like how we're not even back from like commercials, but there's a phone call. It looks like, is this the Underdog?
Yeah.
Underdog, is that you?
Hello? Underdog.
Hello? Underdog, where the fuck are you?
I'm all the way, bitch.
He's on his way? Now he is.
You're on your way. Where are you? I gotta.
Hey, I forgot to call you back. Hey, dude. Hey, Diego, Underdog. Hey, Underdog. Hey, I forgot to call you back.
Wait, where are you?
I'm on the 2 line. I'm on the metro.
No, he's not.
Are you
bullshit.
Fucking? Are you for? Are you kidding me?
This nigga's bullshit. You know he's fucking bullshit.
I'm on the 710 and 91.
All right, then we'll don't die or anything. We'll see when you get here, drunk ass.
I'm fucking have a bowl ready for me.
Wait.
Have a bowl ready for him.
Someone has no work tomorrow.
I have a badger pole ready for you. Badger pole.
Maybe this is it. Maybe Ooh. This is it.
Right?
I'll play
right?
some Cure in a minute. All right, Underdog. We'll see you when you get here.
All right, fucker.
All right. I guess we're going to finish the commercials real quick.
Yeah, let's go back to
it. Check out the new 4G phones. The Sprint HTC Evo and the Sprint Samsung Epic are here. Both have flash players, so you can stream DX Radio live anywhere in the country. So if you're one of those out there having trouble getting your hands on one of these new, cool, special phones, call Arturo at the Signal Hill Sprint store. He's at 562-225-8443. That's Arturo at 562-225-8443. We welcome all new and existing customers.
Kylo's Pizza, family owned and operated in Downey since 1964. That's a long time, folks. Kylo's Pizza, where is it? Same place it's always been, 13230 Woodruff Avenue at Foster. Not only do we have great sandwiches, we got awesome pasta specials, but besides that, let me tell you something, folks. We got the best pizza around. You want to know how I know? Because I'm Italian and I love real, authentic Italian pizza. Where are you going to find that? I'll tell you where. Carlos. No event is too big or too small. We do catering over here. That's what I'm talking about. We cook all the food. You eat all the food. You're going to love it. Let me tell you something. We also got delivery. You're at home. You're watching the playoffs. You don't want to leave the couch. Give Carlos a call. We're going to come over there and bring you some pizza at 562-803-6753. Oof, my. Well, our pizza is the best pizza in town. We got all kinds of sizes, from little itty bitty all the way to a party size. It's almost 2 feet long. Maron, I'm talking about 2 feet long. That's a bigger pizza. You know what I'm saying? 562-803-6753. Carlos Pizza. Or we make a pizza you can't refuse.
Hey guys, if you want to step your game up, go to LibbyGrow.com now for your free sample of the best natural sexual enhancement product available. Find out why millions of men choose LibbyGrow when they want the fun to last and last. No order to place, no club to join, just a free sample. Go to LibbyGrow.com now to get your free sample. Not because you need it, because you want it.
Just so you know, I only date guys who listen to Pigs Radio.
Welcome to Pigs Radio. It is that time, Sunday.
Yeah. Everyone, if you sit on a fucking box and bang on it.
Think that's okay. But this is
banging
what we like right now.
You should have had your headphones on. You would have heard what it said.
It's time for us to share what
I heard a paper bag with holes in it.
All right, everyone's favorite sing-along song at home. Come on, Badger, do it.
Let's ask these guys to do another song for us, man. This song sucks.
Yeah. A ska song. Pigs.
Check it. See, a ska version of it. Pick it up. No. Marijuana, anybody?
1997.
What kind of ska band doesn't fucking smoke weed, man?
We are
Pigs Radio, and we're queer.
Straight Edge Ska.
Episode 190. Yeah. Hanging out with the guys from Matamoska. Now, that was a very, very ska-ish song. It was really fun. And I like the Konami code in there. I like that. Yeah. Up, down, BA, select,
that,
start.
That was actually the point of the song.
Konami code?
Yeah.
Like, yeah. It's like
How do I write a song about the Konami Code? Exactly. That's exactly what we did.
There's a bunch of stuff going on right now. Badger, you're right there?
I'm good.
Oh, okay.
Does Badger know the Konami Code?
Badger has a Konami Code printed inside her vagina. Trust me. Everyone knows the Konami
Code. Oh, totally.
Left, right.
BA, select, start.
Foreplay.
Wow.
Now, do you guys have a lot of stuff on YouTube? Or
we have a lot of stuff on YouTube.
YouTube,
we have this new song called Doom Boogie.
Oh, yeah.
What's that about?
It's called about Doom Boogie.
Is it about Disneyland?
No, it's actually an instrumental song. So a lot of ska bands, what they do,
right?
A lot of ska bands write songs without words in them. It's called instrumental songs.
Whoa.
Very original. I've never heard of it.
What?
What?
And so we wrote this song, and we wrote it like in a day.
Shut the fuck up!
Maybe like a day and a half.
We wrote it in a day and a half and recorded like in a day, like in 3 hours.
It's God.
It's called Doom Boogie. Yeah. Doom Boogie. It's actually a pretty good song if you can pull it up.
I'm looking for it.
Yeah, we probably won't.
D-U-U.
We have it here.
Oh, okay, well, okay. Well, let's check that shit out.
Yeah, for sure.
Let's do it. Instrumental?
Yeah,
it's going to be so awesome.
We wrote
that
it
makes
in
tape real quick, though.
No, think about it. It's a day and a half and then like 2 hours of recording.
So are you explaining why it's so bad or why it's so good?
Exactly, both. But
it's so bad that it's good.
Like Michael Jackson's bad.
Too late. Somebody already sang. Somebody said woo woo and shit. It's not an instrumental anymore. You already fucked up. Blow, blow, blow. Oh shit, who said that? I heard that in the recording. Somebody said that shit.
Very mysterious nigga said that.
I told you I'm a hype man, fool. I should have been in there producing this shit. Son. That's some royalties.
Hey, they're right. There was words in there. Liar.
Yeah, it's not a true instrument. But listen, it's a good song. It is a good song. I like it. I could get blunted to this shit, you know what I mean?
Blunted.
Blood clot. Ooyakasha! I'm telling you.
Pai Safari.
Pai Safari.
Oh, shit. That bomb-ass guitar solo right there.
Sit. This guy right here.
It's like fucking Carlos Santana's little brother Chewy Santana right here.
I tell you who it's not. It's not Wilbur.
That's right. What the fuck, Wilbur?
Definitely not Wilbur.
You're busy handing out flyers outside the studio.
You hear my mixtape.
Here comes some real fire, though.
Here comes the birthday boy right here.
Very organy. I don't know.
Very orgasmic.
It's like I'm just touching the organ and shaking it.
So that's the lover man over there on the couch doing the horns, right?
Yeah.
But that's like a bunch of horns.
Yeah, it's him and all.
It's called the magic of Pro Tools, my friend.
Shit, dude. Multi-track shooting ass motherfucker there. Listen. This shit is not a fucking instrumental. There's too much talking going on in this song, man.
That's what I was saying.
Most of it was you.
Oh, listen, I kind of hyped it up for them. You know, I had to add my own little flavor to it and shit. Yeah. I want royalties, though, if you guys use my shit. Fire.
A very mysterious flavor.
A very, very.
I liked it. That's
very
something.
It's the Musterious remix. That's what it was.
Now, just to let everyone know, in between that song, the underdog finally walked into the studio.
Drunk as
what's up, underdog?
Very drunk. Very fucking drunk.
You are very Asian-y right now. Look, hey. Look, he's giving you a mic right there.
I want to point the irony because USC won yesterday, so they're technically not the underdog.
What's up, you motherfucker?
Bitch ass nigga.
Technically not the underdog, bro. They won yesterday.
No, trust me, I'm an underdog.
USC is definitely not the underdog, bro.
You don't know his the odds.
I don't know his life.
I watched the foosball, my friends. I watched it yesterday. It's good. Good game.
Underdog, thanks for coming down. Now, you were I got a text from you saying you were stranded out in Belmont Shore, right?
Yeah, dude. I was
how'd you even get here?
Was it gay pride today or what?
Like, is it gay pride?
Yeah, I fucking rolled on the gay guy's back here, dude.
Whoa. On the gay guy's back?
With your penis literally inside of him while he was
all right. Right.
Nah, but yeah.
Doggy style, my friends.
Been drinking since 1 o'clock and fucking 49ers got their ass whooped, so...
Yeah, to celebrate
drinking
that?
My pain away.
Oh, shit. Double game shit. Yeah, fucking San Francisco and Belmont Shore.
Yeah, we're fucking drinking out in Long Beach and got stranded and we had to take call like 5 Ubers and...
How'd you get stranded when you had your car over there?
No, my car was in my homie's house in Long Beach.
Oh, okay.
So what I was going to say, five so Ubers and like $8 later. I was like, oh, I was home.
Yeah, man, it was fucking mission, but fuck you guys.
Well, glad to see that you're here. You're probably going to get more drunk and yeah, so
probably, yeah.
Thanks for tuning
already,
in.
I took like 5 hits already and...
Five hits.
Hey, man.
I smoke all
it's
the
my
marijuana.
Birthday today. I'll match whatever you do.
Whoa.
I'll match it.
Oh. What, a rap battle or what?
Oh.
Whatever you do, I'll match it.
Now, okay, so we have a thing here on Pigs Radio. We just started. It's a really bad segment, but it's called...
It's horrible, but
it's called
time.
Rap Battle, and you rap battle the underdog.
I can't rap. I can't rap, but I'll match whatever you do.
Oh, you're going to win. You're going to win then.
But I'm not a rapper.
Yeah.
You're I'm not a rapper.
You automatically win against the underdog.
Dude, the only rap we know is the theme song from Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
Exactly. That's still a better rap.
Word.
That's still better.
In West Philadelphia.
Yeah, I was born and raised.
we'll all do it on him.
All right, and if
it'll
you
be
guys
underdog versus Mata Mosca,
if you guys can all rap together one line at a time to rap battle the underdog.
Let's do it.
Well, okay. Down.
All right, let them go first and
fresh
then underdog
beat,
do the
up?
Rebuttal.
Wait, who's going first? This is gonna be bad.
This is gonna be really bad.
I'm right super here. Fucked right up here. Right now, and
well, who knows?
It
maybe.
Might be better.
Underdog.
It might be better.
You're moving
or worse.
With your auntie and uncle in there.
We'll find out.
I'm just telling you right now, dude.
I rap like Dylan.
I'll just do it. Call me Nike. Oh. All
right. Well, hold on.
Hold on. Don't spit your game right now. Just hold
you're
up.
You're going to blow your load way too fucking fast. Hold on. All right. So we're going to rap battle the underdog here on Pigs Radio. And it's been an ongoing episode. We did it with a bunch of psychobillies that don't know what the fuck. What the fuck?
Whoa.
The fuck, Mario?
I think you have the... The fucking award for most rap battles of the day.
You have the
consecutive losses.
By the way, you have the award. You have the award for most losses in a rap battle. All right. Here we go. So we're gonna do one rap battle. 10 billion guys versus underdog.
I'm gonna do beatbox right here, dude.
Whatever you guys want to do, you're all more than welcome to go ahead and go.
I'm gonna beatbox. Because that's my dream.
All right, well, do that. Count them off.
His whole life, his parents told him he couldn't.
This is like the culmination of my life. It's the beatbox.
Eminem.
It's like the vocal drummer right here.
All right, so at this point, any DJ one of you guys Cam. Can start off the rap.
Any one of you guys can rap. We're starting it. All right.
Come on, bring it.
We're going to start. Yeah, we're going to start.
Let's sing it.
Bros.
Bro.
Hey, start with the hook, though, so we know.
All right.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, go.
This is a story. Are we going to do that? We're really going to do the Fresh Prince?
All right,
we'll do the Fresh Prince.
We're coming in.
That's kind of a cheat, dude.
Ready?
Just do it.
1, 2, 3. In West Philadelphia, born and raised on the playgrounds, where I spent most of my days
chilling out, relaxing, all cool.
Playing some bigger
things. Couple of guys that were up to no good. Started making trouble in my neighborhood. I'm a little fight, my mom got scared and said, "You're moving with your auntie and uncle, bitch."
All right, that was good. That was fucking awesome.
Hey, so we win though.
Well, now we need the rebuttal from underdog.
He has to finish it. He has to finish it.
Hit him with that super hot fire on the dog.
Spit out that lyric, son.
I'm going to go off.
I'll hype you. I'll hype you.
Because I can't fucking hear shit.
Boots, bats,
I ain't got no microphone.
No, 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 no,
hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on.
I have headphones, but.
Wait, what?
He needs headphones.
I have no headphones.
He needs headphones.
Yeah, headphones right there, dude.
Oh, okay.
Give me some gangster ass West Coast shit.
Boots and pots and boots and pots and boots and pots.
Pull up. I'll be Nate Dogg on the hook.
Pull up them 808, son.
Boots and pots. I'm going to face a wall.
All right, hold on, hold on.
Because I get shy.
Give him the most niggerish beat ever.
He's doing the Doors approach to rapping. I love that. Morrison approach to rapping. Do not face the audience.
All right, are you going to play hide and seek right now, too? All right.
You got to give him the most niggerish beat ever. Niggers.
Boots and pats and boots and pats and boots.
All right, underdog, here's your.
That's racist.
Make
bro.
That beat extra niggery.
That's West Coast. My nigga is the best coast. What? What?
This guy fucking jerk off. Fucking jerk off over there behind the batter. What the fuck?
Put some context to this. He's behind like a curtain.
Well, like a, he looks like a 5-year-old trying to take a shit in a diaper and shit.
I get a little tired. Alright, here we go. Fuck you, motherfuckers. Where you at, bitch? Badger? What up? You rapping my shit? Give me a kiss, so what? Yeah. I'm fucked up, bitch. What? Give me a suck? Whoa. I just go with the flow. Nigga, dick? It's bigger than mine. Yes. That shit got big. What? I'm fucked up.
All right.
All right. That was such a washout.
That was really bad. Yeah. But
DJ Khaled.
It wasn't as bad as some of the other ones.
I think he won,
it's actually
though.
A bit
you think he won?
I think he won.
All right.
I think you won, too.
I won for once? What?
You finally won one by default.
There you go. There you go.
Because all they did was recite Fresh Prince of Bel-Air instead of it being a fucking freestyle.
But we did it in unison.
In unison.
That means
we lost. Not that marching band shit here, dude.
So if you guys need an opening act for your next show, just let me know. You know,
I'm down, bro.
I'm pro bono.
No one wants it, dude. No one wants it.
I know. It's all right. It's all right.
All right. Since we have Matamosca in the house, we're going to do a very pigsy thing and do a pigs radio story. So you guys follow along, chime in, especially about this one. Badger, there was a story in the news. And for whatever reason, it did not remind me about you, but you know what? It had to do with vaginas, so it kind of really did.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Very vagina-y.
Very. Mm-hmm. It's a really fucked up story, but, you know, here we go.
Together. Bogota News crime specialist John Turchin is live with more. John.
I got to tell you, when I read the arrest report, my stomach turned. It is one of the most disgusting, horrific murders that I have covered in my...
Okay, so very like disgusting
some,
murder.
Some pussy got murdered. I hear you.
I don't
you.
Know. St. Hans, what?
That's why I wrote
yes,
hers.
I know this story.
Don't say anything. Does anyone
about
else,
me.
Does anyone else know about the story?
I know about the story.
I don't know.
Okay, so for the people who don't know about the story, go around. Badger, what do you think it's about? Most heinous thing he's ever heard in his life.
I always go last.
Okay, whatever. Flat shirt guy.
It's about last Thursday for sure.
Okay, I don't know what that means.
No
guy
one
goes.
Does. It's just some provocative.
What happened?
Some dirty head shit or something.
Dirty head shit. All right.
Shit. It has to do with vagina.
Okay, yes. But I already said that, so that doesn't count.
No, I'm just asking. Oh, it's relevant
yeah.
to vagina.
Okay. Vaginas.
Somebody fucking heinous crying. Somebody... cut off a bunch of vaginas on bitches or something.
Okay, no. cut off vagina lips. All right, there we go.
Someone forgot to put the toilet seat down.
Okay, vagina. Has nothing to do with vaginas. Kind of, well, okay, I'll give them that. Yeah. All right.
Mine has nothing to do with the vaginas, but I think it's a Cleveland steamer gone wrong.
Okay.
Yeah. I think somebody took a shit on somebody's chest and it's just
gone
wrong.
Right.
Cincinnati boat.
Gone right. All right.
A hot Carl.
It's about a chick got stabbed in the snatch. Bam.
With a penis.
Damn, homie.
Yeah. That was the most heinous
twisted. Like prison style and shit.
That's my, right here.
Dude, that's my pickup line. I'm going to stab you in the vagina.
This dude's over there busy making out and shit.
I know.
You're
part of the band right now. Like, I'm going to bow my girlfriend to the couch.
I was like, hey, man, there's a couch here, homie. I'm going to get down. That's it.
You know you're like finger banging her while we're not even paying attention? What the fuck?
He's getting a handy over there and shit all low key with the little fucking comforter over his fucking lap.
Triple X pigs radio.
Yeah, okay, true spit, yeah. It's definitely some Black Dahlia shit right there, right?
Black Dahlia.
Something black for sure.
It's some
something black. All right.
It's some cannabis
today, Stephen.
All right, let's all listen as a class and figure out what happened.
Career, the things that this man admits to doing to this woman, especially when you consider this is the woman he is in love with,
he ate the booty,
are unimaginable, wait, unspeakable.
How heinous.
By the way, for the band, eating the booty is unspeakable? Is that what I heard right now?
No, it's speakable.
It's speakable.
You know this, man.
Hey, it's talkable.
Hey, true talk, though. If you don't freak your girl, someone else will.
Oh, Badger, you agree?
It's true.
When I toss my salad, I prefer syrup.
Syrup. No, it's not syrup. It's syrup.
Syrup. I'm sorry, dude. I work with white people.
S-U-R-A-Y-P. Syrup.
Aura.
Heard some disturbing phrases and descriptions in this report.
Good morning, Mr. Lopez.
Buenos días, señor Lopez.
Fidel Lopez stands accused of what very well may be one of the most horrifying murders you'll ever come across. The 24-year-old confessing to beating, sexually mutilating, and disemboweling his girlfriend.
I do find probably
disemboweled.
Lopez says it was in a tequila-fueled fit of rage that led him to kill his
Of course it was tequila.
Hey, the new album.
By the way, tequila makes you do the weirdest shit.
Those cazadores, fool.
Take naked pictures of the people.
That cazador blanco, man. That $20 bottle.
That's reposado right there, homie.
Reposado, my nigga.
I feel for that guy, dude, because that one time I drank a lot of tequila and it took a really droopy shit, so. It does make you do a lot of weird shit you don't want to do.
This shit looks sad. It was so droopy.
I agree.
I just left the toilet paper in my asshole. I was depressed looking at that shit.
But the reason why is most disturbing. It's all here in the arrest affidavit. Because he says she blurted out her ex-husband's name twice.
Oh yeah, I did hear about this one.
So,
she deserved that and more.
So you guys agree it's okay to rip out a fucking female's intestines when she calls out someone else's dude's name?
Why are you doing her?
Wow. Nah.
Yeah.
Wait.
I want to hear from the. I want to hear from the two. Well, I'm sorry, from the three girls in the house.
What do you?
Pass the phone. Pass the mic.
Pass the mic.
All right. Is it okay for you to get hurt in the vagina if you call out someone else's name in bed?
No?
Isn't that okay for you to be hurt?
At that point, you'd be caught slipping, though, dude.
Cut to the mic.
My virgin ears.
Have her sit on your lap or some shit, dude.
Get her right.
We'd be calling a nigga's name out, but they'd be thinking of somebody else without saying it, so it's like...
Oh.
Message! Message
today on Mari. CPT.
I'll remember that.
Hey, Platcher.
Message.
Hey, Platcher. Who are you thinking about?
Wait. I think it's okay as long as you say finish him.
True life. I'm sleeping on the couch.
By the way, on the show, we've broken up a few bands before, and we've broken up a podcast, but looks like we're going to break up our first fucking couple. Have we broken up couples?
They had to do with the band.
Wait, was Badger involved?
That's right.
I think Badger was involved.
Jose Luis.
Have you been busted for calling him? No? Okay. But you've been busted for thinking about someone else.
Nope.
Yes.
No proof. Plead the fifth. No proof.
By the way, she told me you talk in your sleep and you say everything, so I don't know.
He's gonna be like Badger.
Badger.
Show your tits.
Smelly heart.
Badger, what do you think? At this point, I mean, I know you're a big whore, and you probably have like a Rolodex of names that you can blur out.
Well, that's why you stick to God and Jesus.
Whoa.
That way it doesn't matter.
And if you guys name Jesus, just really quick.
Jesus goes down.
Jesus right there.
Joe.
Joseph.
She's like, nah, I'm Badger.
She's going to be calling my name out, too.
Whoa. She does that.
That would mean you're like elbow in, though, right?
Wait, yobo limbo.
No, you're like elbow in to pull intestines out.
Well, yeah, you're going pretty fucking. Yeah. Oh, let's hear the story.
There's a black cloud hanging over this apartment complex now. The neighbors are sad. It's a horrible loss.
It happened inside the couple's third floor apartment at the Colonnade Residences in Sunrise, where Nemeth worked in the leasing office for the past five years.
That sounds Mexican. She was a very
By the way, she's really hot, she's too. Hot. I mean, I would definitely rip out her intestines, too. That's how hot she is.
Yeah, but you try to rip
hey,
it out.
Why are you getting up? Sit down. Your chick's right
you
there.
You got a little lady. Dude, this is trying to size up.
Y'all niggas need to see her face right now.
This is why you get in trouble.
This motherfucker. Out of everybody in the fucking room, he's the only motherfucker that got up to go take a lift. The nigga with the motherfucker.
Dude, I left my San Luis. Austin.
The nigga with the only nigga in the room with a girl here. Well, I'm sorry. There's another one over there, of course. Yes. But the only nigga at the table, this motherfucker with his old lady back here trying to get up to size up the bitch and shit.
By
what
way,
the fuck are you thinking, dude? Come on, man.
Did you guys meet at a show or where did you guys meet at real quick?
Actually, yeah, we did.
A groupie.
So you're a band groupie.
No, not that. We met at a show years ago. Years ago.
Oh, hold on. You
she stalked me. Stalked me.
Well, at least we have girls who admit that shit.
Keyword
sounds
stalk.
Like a badger.
So keyword. It sounds like another Wilbur. She doesn't get the point.
Oh well.
Oh.
Too hype, man.
Gonna pay for that later.
I'm gonna hear from this later. I'm gonna hear from this later.
Say goodbye to your penis.
Pleasant, lovely, Yana.
No,
we all just absolutely loved her to death.
Lopez told detectives he became a monster, yelling, smashing a sliding glass door and window, and punching holes in walls.
I only heard a loud noise at one point, but then, I mean, I didn't think much of it.
The worst was ahead. Lopez later telling detectives he then began to violently assault Nemeth, sexually mutilating her with such force he ripped out her intestines.
As far as what he did, I mean, I really have no words.
Two lives are lost, you know? He has no freedom now. He's going to jail forever, and yeah, she's lost.
I'd probably rip her intestines out, too.
El Fidel Lopez.
So, yeah, so he fucked her up.
Hey, on behalf of all Mexicans, we don't all do that. Ladies.
No, does that make her a hoe for like calling out her ex-husband's name?
Well, that's kind of the thing, though. You know what I mean? It's like how
you're a dumbass for sure.
Like, yeah, how stupid do you have to be to call like fucking you know you got your old man right there.
Not as much, but twice.
Exactly.
Here we go again. Cyclone flashbacks.
There was a fucking hoe in the house and shit, but that bitch is gone now.
Sure is.
I mean, how fucking, how stupid can she be that she fucking blurts out some other guy's fucking name?
Hey, but
you know what's funny, though? She must have blurted out because he must have been fucking her like the other dude.
That's
you know what I'm saying?
Right. This reminds me of that old dick. That
like, so fuck yeah, dude.
TBT right there.
Listen, I say it was deserved, man. Fuck that bullshit.
All right.
Hey, no, but true spit, like, on that point, like, if he was doing her like her old man.
On the couch, Mario.
Okay, I'm like, who the fuck is talking? I'm like, God?
Who's the fucking ventriloquist in the room? You know?
Hey, it's the ghost of that bitch, dude.
Throwback dick. Throwback dick right there.
All right, so what?
Remember. So, couch lover.
Couch lover.
You know what I like, Trispit.
What's up, Lucy?
If he was doing her like her old man, it's because she was telling him how to do her because she's still in love with the old man. So
it was psychological.
The whole time.
That was deep.
She wasn't even,
Hey, play all right,
okay, so the crazy girl needs a mic. Someone give her a fucking mic.
Yeah,
she needs to talk.
She's never ready. No. Hey, I'm not passing my motherfucker.
Why don't you come sit on his lap, fucking reverse call girl style, and talk into the mic.
Come on. Just write
him. Yeah, finish that beer.
Write him. That's your man anyway. Write this fool.
All right. Closer.
Listen, pretend you're talking to his penis.
Yeah, get in there.
That's what I'm
talking about. You know you like it.
It's true.
It's true.
God damn it.
If she's calling the other nigga's name, because she still obviously loves the other nigga.
Well, then, yeah.
Well, maybe not.
That's not true.
She's
fucking you, but she's thinking of somebody else. That's not true.
What if he's fucking her whack like the other nigga?
Go.
I do that.
Inception.
I thought we were on.
You knew.
No.
That's some Inception type shit.
I'm very terrible at sex.
What do you call that? Else. Obviously, you're liking somebody
get
else.
Closer.
I can see the type of relationship they have.
I can see it.
Baby, hello.
So,
that is true. Put away just going to the same bar.
Baby, put away the teeth.
By the way, I am scared for you when you go home. You're gonna get beat up tonight for sure. Somehow. It's
gonna
happen.
He's gonna get the worst blowjob ever.
Gotta get gray.
It's violent.
You gonna bite his dick off?
SpongeBob with the chocolate box.
A lot of teeth.
He might not even get one.
Oh.
That is
is the worst blowjob ever.
I bet you who will get a blowjob tonight.
The guy that's the quietest will get a blowjob tonight.
It was like, I'm playing though.
I'm going to guess this story is from fucking Florida, bro.
I have hope.
I don't know. I just wanted to play that.
Wait, where's the story from, dude? Florida?
Probably. They all come from Florida.
Texas or Florida? It's like 95% Florida.
Florida man reaches. Yeah, it's Florida.
Oh, dude, man. No wonder.
Fucking Florida.
Totally expected.
All right. Let's see. I think we should hear another band song real quick. Do you guys got something else on your cellular phones?
We got the Jefes.
El Jefe de Ska.
Yeah. Hey, listen, while he's queuing up the song, I do have a question for the band.
Jefe de Ska.
And it's a serious question. It's a business question. I'm a promoter outside of this. I got to ask you guys, how much do you guys charge? Like a rough number.
Not enough.
Because I was going to say, how many band members are there?
There's like eight of us, and we charge like
10 bucks. Okay.
Eight of us?
I mean, eight of you guys.
I'm going to say this once. We're the cheapest, oldest band.
We're pretty affordable. We're like the $2 whores of all the ska scene.
We just love to play.
Because it's like
we'll get the job done.
It's crazy, man. I always see like these 15-member bands up on stage, and they're like fucking Brando's paying them like $10 at the end of the night. You know,
dude. I'll tell you this. There's bands out there like $1,000, $1,015. We're cheaper than that.
We're
losing money playing this.
By the way, I am proud to announce that Matamoska will be playing next Friday at Hunt City at Malabar.
So I don't know how you guys are going to divvy out that $100 that Mario pays you guys at the end of the night.
It's going to cover gas for everyone.
But you guys love the music. $100, more than enough for all eight of you guys.
Give me beer.
Honestly, all bullshit aside,
listen, dude, I'm negotiating for you. They're saying beer money.
All bullshit aside.
Well, you're not even going to be there. Shut the fuck up.
Black me out.
All bullshit aside, guys, for real, like, we do it because we write it and we love it. Like, we just...
And it's fucking fun. We love ska. We love it. Ska's fucking fun.
How'd you guys come up with the name? I know a lot of these ska bands, they have to add the word ska into their name, like Gomez Caca and Carne Ascada and shit like that.
That should be our name. Gomez Caca.
We should be Scappuccino.
And Scalmado and fucking Scalmate, wey, and all that
Scagados.
Shit.
Scandalo.
All that garbage, it all happened in the early... Well, actually, late
in
90s.
The Land Before Time.
Yeah. When it was punny to put that name in your title because it was a pun, basically.
Yeah.
Ska bands were far and few between, and you had to differentiate yourself. Because, I mean, hardcore bands and, like, metal bands have names that make them legit. I mean, like, it'll categorize them for sure.
Right.
Right?
Screwdriver.
You know what's funny? This guy's been
Power Tree.
He's been clowning the whole day, but when it comes to the origins of the band, the two guys, serious, dude.
There you go.
Really fucking bad, man. Philosophical
and shit.
But listen, let me tell you something. The way we came up with the band, I grabbed a fly swatter. I thought this would be a great name of a band.
It's just my art. It's how I express myself.
I fly, yeah, exactly. No, I mean, it's a pun, and we're all about that.
Matamoska transcends. Play the fucking song.
Lives.
Play the song.
Deep as fuck, nigga.
Deep niggas right here.
Bars.
Oh, yeah. All hail and heaven the sky. a matter of fact. Collect all the minions and gather all the pawns. The plan is simple, we go riot and get done. Pick up a brick, tear down the wall. Kick in the door, leave nothing at all. Hell on earth, an Easter Lay Barrio. The mods and the punks and the skins and los vatos.
And the Sprint Samsung Epic are here. Both have flash players, so you can stream.
I was wondering why we were going back to commercials, but we never did them earlier.
So if you're one of those out there having trouble getting your hands on one of these new cool special phones, call Arturo at the Signal Hill Sprint store. He's at 562-225-8443. That's Arturo.
That store is still there.
225-8443.
We welcome all new and
hey, homage.
Carlo's Pizza, family-owned and operated in Downey since 1964. That's a long time, folks. Carlo's Pizza, where is it? The same place it's always been. 13230 Woodrow
Underdog's ready to jump.
I know.
Not only do we have great sandwiches, we got awesome pasta specials. But besides that, let me tell you something, folks. We got the best pizza around. You want to know how I know? Because I'm Italian and I love real, authentic Italian pizza. Where are you going to find that? I'll tell you where. Carlo's. No event is too big or too small. We do catering over here. That's what I'm talking about. We cook all the food. You eat all the food. You're going to love it. Let me tell you something. We also got delivery. You're at home. You're watching the playoffs. You don't want to leave the couch. Give Carlos a call. We're going to come over there and bring you some pizza at 562-803-6753. Oof, Maron. Well, our pizza is the best pizza in town. We got all kinds of sizes from little itty bitty all the way to a party size. It's almost 2 feet long. Maron, I'm talking about 2 feet long. That's a bigger pizza. You know what I'm saying? 562-803-6753. Carlos Pizza. When we make a pizza, you can.
Hey guys, if you want to step your game up, go to LibbyGrow.com now for your free sample of the best natural sexual enhancement product available. Find out why millions of men choose LibbyGrow when they want the fun to last and last. No order to place, no club to join, just a free sample. Go to LibbyGrow.com now to get your free sample. Not because you need it, because you want it.
Your folks,
that's the
plan.
In case you guys don't know, we're chicks, and we love listening to Pigs Radio.
Welcome to Pigs Radio. It is that time, Sunday. Everyone likes yeah. things, and we think that's okay. But this is what we like.
Should
right
I be scared?
Now.
I don't know what's happening.
I don't know, dude. I keep thinking I'm going to get shacked on the side
You're about
of the neck or some shit. Chuco, saca el filero!
You hit somebody with a chair right now.
About to get Love stabbed you. With a checkered style fucking shank. Fuck it.
We're going to be fuck all you levas. Hey, man. Hey, Mario.
It's all you.
Don't
it's all you,
this,
Danny.
Don't let this troll like shank me, bro.
He's going to fuck you up, son.
Jump off the top rope.
She'll kill you.
I'm not sure.
She's like, Scott Life, homie. What's up?
That's it. You guys drink it.
Matamos, cállese.
MSK, homie.
MSK?
Pigs Radio episode 1 day. Wait, what the fuck is happening here? Is there a fight happening? Are you about to die?
Up, nigga.
Wait, hold on. Get her on my. You just what?
I just threatened a nigga.
Oh, okay. Why?
With liquor.
Okay. I don't know what that means.
Damn, I'm scared.
Like, he's gonna lick her.
This is my solution right here.
So I did this.
You guys should tape your guys' hands together and, like, each gets a knife and fucking Michael Jackson style.
I'm Thunderbird.
Yeah,
I'm a Thunderbird, bro. No, I'm a Thunderbird. I'm a Thunderbird. All right.
Nah, so let me get you all up to date. She made me a drink, and it's like a super mixed drink. It's like the jungle juice of this radio show right now.
And I put
super bomb. Does it have badgers coming? Padilla's pouring beer in it.
By the way,
dude. Oh my god,
I just seasoned it with some Bud Light. Like, no cocktail can go wrong with Bud Light on top of it, dude. I'm just saying, like, he's walking home, so it's like,
just
all good.
Bud Light is fucking water ass beer, nigga.
That's what's gonna fuck you up.
That's a nice water. Are you on a diet? Is that a water bottle?
Hey, Bud Light's our beer sponsor. That's why we have so much here.
It's friendship beer.
Just kidding. Bud Light.
All the to the camera.
My daughter was born because of Bud Light.
So, by the way, did anyone else catch that? He just said that's the jungle juice of this show. I don't know. Wait, yeah. Stop touching that shit. You were cool.
It moved.
No, it didn't.
Oh, it didn't move. God damn it. Back down,
stop fucking moving that shit.
Hey, fuck you.
Fuck you.
Let's get out of control.
I want to know if Matamoska can write a song about Pigs Radio and about the badger.
I will do
actually,
it.
Actually,
I will do it.
We will do it.
We're actually writing an album right now, so.
Oh. I highly doubt that's going to make the album, but if it does, I want to call Pigs Radio.
You should perform it at our
6th annual
Pigs Radio.
I'll definitely bust a squeal in the song. I'll be like, wee!
Wait, now we're making fucking dinosaur noises. Who the fuck just did that?
That was me.
I love you.
That's actually a really good dinosaur now.
You love me.
God damn it.
All it took was a ton of Bud Light to get him to loosen up. All right.
I keep forgetting there's people on the couch, by the way.
Are you done finger banging each other?
No.
Do me a favor, my dear. Definitely. Can you grab his dick real quick? Yeah, just grab it. Grab his dick. Grab his dick.
Did you see how he grabbed it? How she grabbed his dick like this? Like, I got you, nigga.
Cariño. She surely got me. Normally, descarado right there.
That is a little bit different because I seen Badger out of the cyclone grab dicks with her fucking asshole. So it's the weirdest thing ever.
Just fucking
asshole grabbing.
Yank dicks out of the.
All right. Please check out Matamoska happening at Mal's October 2nd.
Right. Yeah.
This Friday.
Friday. It's going to be a Halloween costume just party. Right. Dress up. Badger, what are you coming as? Whore or what?
Slut bag. Slut bag.
Wait, slip bag?
Straight up slut bag.
I don't know what that means.
A virgin.
What?
I'm not coming.
You're always
coming.
That's
what she said.
That's so sad.
Was that Platt guy? Is that who said that?
I said that.
Did you see him right now? He's like.
By the way, in between the songs, he was out there making finger promising. Like, I'm never gonna do that, baby. Like, I'm always gonna remember your name. Right. I saw that.
I swear
shit.
I wasn't looking.
Saw that shit.
I swear I wasn't looking at that chick on the laptop.
By the way, when you pinky promise a cholo like that, you know that shit's fucking legit.
That's legit,
like,
man.
That shit's locked in. If not, he's gonna get his dick cut off.
Straight up, I'm gonna call my Theo fucking
G,
Spooks.
Dude, you motherfucking G.
Hey Spooks, this dude's fucking up on me. Yes, sir.
Other than that, do you guys have any other upcoming shows that aren't important compared to the Fun City one?
No, the Fun City is the best one.
Yeah,
we're actually releasing a new. Music video that night. Low-key.
What? Are we going to play that in Fun City?
Low-key, high-key.
Exposed key.
It's a music video for the song that we have. It's called Beer Goggles.
Oh, so Badger, now it turned to the official release party of that fucking music video.
Yeah,
it just became official right now.
Big radio exclusive.
I like their sound effect better than my sound effect.
Because
all I have is like an air horn.
World
War II's happening right now.
You got the wrong one. You need the DJ one. You need the DJ one.
I hate that one so much.
But that's what they were doing right
now.
That shit's awesome,
man.
It should work.
We
DJ Cali.
DJ Feli Fell.
We got busted on the beat.
We got the help of a talented director, filmmaker, Carlos.
Marco Tombstone.
That guy's also awesome.
Marco, I'll have your shit ready tomorrow, aka fucking 5 weeks from now.
He did a little bit, but no, this guy's Jesus Olvera. He's a really fucking talented guy. We recorded a music video called Beer Goggles, and it's coming out. It's a really post-productive shit, and it's really awesome looking.
You see, whenever he gets to the bad shit, all of a sudden he gets serious.
Seriously. I don't even know where that music's playing from. I'm like, oh my God. Yeah.
I almost shed a tear, dude. I thought I was watching the ending of a Lord of the Rings movie and shit.
you know what you really wanted to say.
What?
Fucking glittery vampire fucking movie. Fucking right. Faggot.
Full Eclipse.
Twilight movies. There you go. This guy's really into Twilight.
It was an awesome franchise. Shut the fuck up. They make billions of dollars.
Faggot.
Fuck you. Faggot. Fuck you guys. Fuck you guys. I shimmer in the sun night, all right?
Whoa.
You're about to get stabbed from the troll.
Team Edward.
She even said that's fucking gay.
Oh, that's right. She's down for it.
Party
Team Jacob.
She just broke the fucking leg off the chair.
We're some obnoxious Mexicans.
Yes, you are.
Yo, okay, real quick, with a show of hands, how many of you guys are really Mexican?
Badger, put your hand down.
Oh. No, Badger, I said how many of you guys are Mexican, not how many of you guys fucked a bunch of Mexicans.
Oh.
Two hands. Oh, shit. I guess y'all are.
Who was really born in Mexico, though?
What's up, nigga? Wannabes, bitch ass niggas, wannabes.
Hey,
legalize me.
200 years ago. 200 years ago, this one's Mexico. My mom, so.
Who's got the fucking burn mark on the arm?
Right here. Oh, that fucking, yeah, I got that
crazy
shot.
Tetanus
gonna kill
you. I forgot what arm, it's right here, bro.
That's
like
legit.
I'm hepatitis free, motherfucker. Right. Hepatitis free.
I got too much fucking arm hair to fucking see that shit. Bro.
Dude, you just jagging. You're a fucking
somewhere under there.
Dude's got asshole. He doesn't have arm hair. He has asshole hair up there.
I see a lot of muscle and flab.
Yeah, fucking there you
go. All right.
That full swole, but it's like water retention swole.
Now, Mr. Nigga.
She looks swollen.
It's like watching a walrus just go out in nature. It's just,
ooh, just ate a lot of salt and shit.
Nah, but underdog tight.
Now, I need to know, Mr. Nigga, are you going to stay home? Are you going to come out and watch the guys play on Friday? Or are you going to be home watching Twilight?
I'm going to open up for them in my fucking ska psychobilly punk band, Skyco Youth and shit. I'm opening up for these guys.
Skyco and his
Youth?
Band is called Skyco I'm Youth. Coming Out. That's the name of the band. That's it.
That's going to be our track. That's our track right there. That's what we're going to open up with.
By the way, I hear some horns in
I'm
here, too.
I'm wearing gold lame.
And there might be a underdog exclusive first ever performance.
No
live.
One wants to hear you rap.
Coming out. Everybody's coming.
Oh my God. Bitches. Fuck.
It's going to be so hardcore. All
right. One, so, once again, check out Matamosca on the Facebooks, on the internets, on the YouTubes. Chola's still yelling at us. I'm scared right now.
Listen, man.
Hey, dude, you're going to get fucking stabbed, bro. I'm just letting you know right now. Stop thinking about other bitches right now.
Bring it.
Oh, shit.
Straight up.
Jose Luis. Jose Luis.
Se la metieron.
Wait.
True life. I'm going to be dead in like 2 hours.
Hold on. Wait. What'd she say?
Just because I don't have a knife.
Oh.
Not yet.
You know she's got a switchblade in her fucking
hair. Document this.
We have this on YouTube, so it's not real.
The eulogy.
Officer,
you don't need a knife to stab the heart and shit, dude.
Whoa.
Damn. How many ska songs do you have about that?
A lot. Too many.
All right, so please check out Mata Mosca. You know what? Let's see. Who? Okay, spell Mata Mosca for me.
M-A-T-A-M-O-S-A.
Wrong!
All right.
Oh my God.
Hey, yes.
She hasn't been to any fucking Mexican clubs.
And then we're debuting your new music video at the Fun City
Gear
show.
Goggles, do you have that? Yeah. All right, we got to keep up.
Oh, you actually have the song? Oh, yeah, let's listen to it then.
Hey, wait.
Can I have like a semi tender moment real quick?
Okay.
All right.
No,
stop shit. No. All right. I just joined this band like in March.
Bitch, nigga.
Okay. All right, talk up. We can't hear you. Your balls are. Yeah.
Lift the tip.
So. I joined this band back in March. Aww. On like a. I need a. What was it?
Preach, brother. Preach.
For the show, I was doing like a fill in moment, right?
And so you replaced the flyer guy.
It was just a help.
Yeah, I was replacing the help. I was
Wilbur?
I was
I would never be replaced.
I wasn't even the help.
I replaced Wilbur.
I was the help's help.
I mean,
and these niggas took me on, and like within the month I've been in the band, these niggas have grown to be my family, man. I fucking love these cats, man.
This motherfucker is wasted.
I love you guys.
Wait,
who's driving him home? Because he's going to throw up in someone's car tonight.
Hell nah.
By the way, I like how this turned into community drink.
To the dome.
All right.
He's taking an Uber.
We'll dedicate it to him because he's about to cry right now. Like if it's a Vicente Fernandez song.
It's like.
Oh, shit. Leave a message after the tone.
I don't know how we come to say that we went through. Well, I don't know how you've been. Maybe it's better off that way. Well, I'm working up the nerve so that I'll call you up to say that it's 2 o'clock in the morning. I got my feeling goggles on. Hey, that's your mama, I want your loving again. Cause I got my dear goggles on. So nice, it used to be so good. It used to laugh at all my jokes and you said you understood. Now I'm living like a rat, cause I'm living on the street. I have nothing else to give to you. Don't want my cobalt name because it's 2 o'clock in the morning. I got my beer goggles on. Hey, little mama, I'm a yodeling again, cause I got my beer goggles on. So nice, it used to be so good. You used to laugh at all my jokes and you said you understood. Well, it's not summertime and the living's not easy. Cause I know that you will never be coming back for me. Because it's 2 o'clock in the morning. I got my beer goggles on. Hey, but tomorrow I want your loving again. Cause I got my beer goggles on.
There we go, Mata Mosca on Pigs Radio. We're going to be debuting that music video on the 8th at Mouse. Be there or be a fucking queer, you fucking queers. May 2nd. Wait, yeah, right. Okay. Yeah. October. I'm under the influence.
May 2nd.
Wait. Hey, I don't know where the fuck. Where am I? Where am I? I'm so. Look, I'm not going to lie. I'm scared. I feel like I'm going to get stabbed as soon as I get up right now.
You are.
I keep looking behind me, dude, just in case.
I know, dude.
When she got up to get on the mic, I thought I was going to get shivved right there, dude.
I'm like, what? Dead. All right. Thank you. Thank you guys for coming down. Make sure you guys check out Matamoscas, all the onlines and the whatnots and amoebas and everywhere else.
SoundClouds and the fucking MySpaces and all that bullshit.
GeoCities.
Napsters and shit.
And the Midget Mania.
Friendsters. Catch them off Friendster.
Okay, side
catch them on Foursquare.
Catch them everywhere. So on that note, thank you guys for coming down. Check out their shit and pigs out.
Bye.
Hey, yo, DJ, stop the music.
Countdown. 5, 4, 3, 2.
Initiating shutdown sequence.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. You're cool. Fuck you, I'm out.
This show may cause birth defects and or cancer. Void where prohibited in the Southern Red States. Official sponsor of the Special Olympics. Not really. 2% financing available for nothing. See your official Toyota dealer for recall as penalty for not buying American. This show may cause massive amounts of marijuana consumption. This show has been a joint venture of cockballs and ass. Free salad tossing available. Upon request, visit RobertReese.com. Sexual relations among cousins is not incest.
Thank you.
That will conclude this evening's entertainment.